Hello friends, welcome to Docker Essential video series. In this lab session, we are going to perform three lab session on Docker file, and we're going to cover three instructions: from, run, and cmd. Now, to get the better understanding of wide range of technologies in a simple manner, click the subscribe button and hit the bell icon. So let's first do the lab session onto the different instructions. So first instruction I'm going to use is from instruction. We have to create a file called from. So let me create a new file. So this from file is the Docker file, and instead of giving a name called Docker file, I am giving a separate name, okay, because throughout this session we are going to create different Docker files. I'm going to paste this particular content. Okay, this content is available in a GitHub repository. Link for that I'll be going to share in the description. Now, this is the content of this Docker file. So we are only using the one instruction, that is from, which says from Ubuntu, and the version is the latest one. So what will happen when you run this particular, when you create a Docker image from this particular Docker file, it will create an image, okay, which is having Ubuntu as a base image. Okay. Now, the command that we are going to use to build a Docker image is docker build hyphen f. Will tell the name of a Docker file. Next is the hyphen d, which is the tagging of newly created Docker image, and it is going to be this, and the version is 1, and we have to give a context from where the image to be built. So image has been built. We can verify using the docker images instruction, and as you can see, our image is created. Okay, now next we are going to perform the second lab session on the run instruction. So run instruction will execute any commands in a new layer on top of the current image and commits the result. That means while building any Docker image, if you want to execute something in that process, then you have to use a run instruction. For that, let me create a Docker file with a name called run. Okay, and let me paste this content. So the content is, so the first two lines are similar. Now here you will see that run echo hello from shell form, run echo from exec form. So in run instructions, there are two forms, shell form and exec form. So let me save this file. Okay. So let's build a Docker image. So you will see both the things are printed, hello from shell form and hello from exec form. Now in this lab session, the last instruction we are going to cover is cmd. Okay, so cmd instruction is used to execute instructions or command when the container has been started. Okay, but the main purpose of cmd is to provide the defaults for an executing container. So let's see. Let me create a file called cmd. Let's paste the content for that particular Docker file. So it is also a simple Docker file. What I'm going to do is, whenever the container is started, I want this particular hello to be printed. So the difference between run and cmd is, in run, the instructions are executed while creating the Docker image, while in cmd, the instruction is executed when the container is started. So that's the basic difference. Okay, so let me create a Docker image. So this time you will see the hello is not printed. You will see hello is printed. So that's how the CMD instruction works. So that's it for this particular lab session. We have covered from run and CMD instructions. So thank you for watching this video. Please like, share, and comment on the video and subscribe the channel.